Welcome back to Armchair Directors. We are doing our year in review, best part, worst part of 2010. Now it's time for one big massive turd alert, the worst of 2010.
You know, for the most part, there were some decent movies in 2010, but there were some of the worst movies I've ever seen. The king of this turd alert has got to be Ben Stiller and Robert De Niro slumming it a third time in Little Fockers.
I wouldn't know. I haven't seen it.
Mercifully so. We were talking about Toy Story 3 being a great third in a series, and this series is out of gas for sure. The Fockers is just awful.
You're saying the Focker trilogy didn't end on a good note?
Who would have thought?
Oh, no.
Now, how I fooled myself into thinking that the trailers were maybe just, you know, showing the worst parts of the movie, and then I should give Ben Stiller and Owen Wilson and De Niro the benefit of the doubt, I will regret that decision for all of 2011, but because I sat through the awfulness that was the Fockers without a single chuckle in 95 minutes, not even a smile, you don't have to, so your year will be bright and shiny.
Next is one of my picks, Legion, which was just garbage. Despite having Dennis Quaid in it. Dennis Quaid, one of my favorite actors, but just can't make a good movie to save his career, literally.
Some people got to get paid.
Yeah. Next, we've got another one I luckily missed, The Last Airbender by M. Night Shyamalan.
Just terrible. I hated every minute of it. If you saw the trailer, you saved yourself the heartache and the frustration. Airbender made no sense. I'm seething just thinking about the
I think the only good thing that came out of The Last Airbender was our review.
And if you haven't seen it, check it out on our website, armchairdirectors.com. We really went to town on that one.
Yeah, we went all out with the wind gimmick because of the airbending.
Now,
and all that.
I unfortunately saw the sequel to Sex and the City, Sex and the City 2, where the ladies decided to go to Egypt and ride around on camels, and it was just one of the worst movies I've ever seen. Even fans of the show, I've heard, have hated it. And there's just a ridiculous scene where they dress up in this Indian garb. I can't go on because it's painful to think about, but if you skipped Sex and the City 2, you were smarter than me, and hopefully we will never see a Sex and the City 3 unless it's just 10 minutes and, you know, a bomb goes off and it's over.
What is You Again?
You Again is a terrible movie that I saw, so you didn't have to. Starring Kristen Bell, Sigourney Weaver, Jamie Lee Curtis. And it was billed as this really wacky comedy about this girl who finds out her brother is going to marry her high school nemesis. And then we find out that her mother-in-law was her mom's high school nemesis. And it sounds really wacky and fun. And the trailer made it seem light and fluffy. And then the movie happened. And it was just awful. And Sigourney Weaver is trying to get laughs. And you just feel embarrassed for everyone who's attached to this turd. And speaking of Kristen Bell, who was the star of You Again, she made one of the worst romantic comedies I've ever seen with Josh Duhamel called When in Rome, which had Will Arnett and Napoleon Dynamite in it. And just from start to finish, not a single joke works. There's no romance in it. I just felt like someone was poking me in the eye and going, this is funny, right? This is funny, right? This movie's funny, right?
And then to round out the list, one I just recently saw on Blu-ray, The Other Guy, starring Will Ferrell and Mark Wahlberg. Now, I'm a big Will Ferrell fan, but I admit that there's good Will Ferrell and there's bad Will Ferrell. And bad Will Ferrell is when he beats a dead horse. And I have never seen a horse beaten, a dead horse beaten longer and more cruelly than in The Other Guys. This was absolutely horrible. And my wife walked out on the viewing and I forced myself to sit through the entire thing just because I have this show. And I felt the responsibility as a movie reviewer to maybe, you never know, even in the last minute, something can turn the tide. It did not turn the tide. It was absolutely the worst Will Ferrell movie I have ever seen. And this is stunning to me, but this is the worst Mark Wahlberg movie I've ever seen. And I've seen The Happening.
See, I thought The Other Guys was at least tolerable. There's some great Will Ferrell moments throughout. It doesn't go off like gangbusters like Talladega Nights, but 50 times better than Max Payne, The Happening, Megamind. So if you like goofy Will Ferrell, I thought it was funny. But
I thought not.
It was like a soup kitchen for you.
So all in all, 2010 was really one of the most incredible years for movies I've seen in a long, long time. It reminded me of the mid-80s when, you know, it just seemed like every movie I was watching back then had incredible magic to it.
Uh-huh.
And yeah, just an incredible number of great movies in 2010. And it looks like 2011 is going to be more of the same.
I hope so. There's a lot of big blockbusters on tap. And if they deliver like the ones this year did, we should be in for a treat.
So check us out every week on TV and on the web. And we'll tell you all about those hopefully great films. Thanks a lot for watching, and until next time,
enjoy the show. And you should know, what do you return? Well, it's been about 3 years since I first met your face. Talk about people getting sad.